Hey, it's Hanasaurus, and today we are back on our School of Dragons playthrough. So Snifflesnuff is almost an adult. Once he reaches level 10, we can age him up to an adult dragon, and then we can fly on him. So that's gonna be awesome. But for now, let's just go pick up a quest here. The headmaster has one for us. Birkguard, help needed. We need brave young dragon trainers to join the Birkguard. Do you think you have what it takes? I believe in you, I believe in you, student. Talk to Astrid on the way to the training grounds to get started. Alright. So we're gonna join the Birkguard or something.
Yeah! You're the Viking!
I'm glad you're joining us, Hanasaurus. I've been watching your progress and I know you're definitely up for the task. We need to be vigilant to defend the school from those who want to attack us.
Help me out!
Over the past few months, I've spotted a lot of enemy ships sailing near our island. They haven't attacked yet, but it's only a matter of time. We need to be ready. We've seen some berserker ships, and even some ships sailing the symbol of the outcasts. Let's go to the training grounds, where we'll need to defend ourselves. Oh wow, are we under attack right now?
I have to admit, you're pretty amazing.
When the ships appear, we'll need to fly out and fight the invaders as they approach the island. If we all work together, we will be able to sink the invaders, avoid the counterfire and blasts of the ships. If you get low on health, you'll need to refill your dragon's shot limit. Fly to one of the safe camps, you'll see a golden glow from the camp. Alright.
I'm counting on you.
If I see an attacking ship on the horizon, I'll send out a battle event warning for you to come to the training grounds and help fight them off. I don't know when they'll come, so be on your guard. You should try out different dragons, as each has unique attributes that will change the way you fight in battle. Thanks, Hanasaurus. I'm sure you'll do proud. The Birkguard proud. Okay. Well, I know exactly when the ship is coming. 39 minutes and 30 seconds. Anyways. I guess that was that quest, so it appears Astrid has a quest for us now. Alright, we'll do Bodies of Water.
What a beautiful day for standing around outdoors!
Dragon training can be really hectic, so the sound of running water relaxes me. I love how the light hits the water. I think it's the most beautiful thing in the School of Dragons. You should go check out all the bodies of water here. Start by finding a signal by the lake. Right. Oh, I just noticed we are an inch away from level 10. Visit the lake at the school. I'm guessing that's the fishing lake that they're referring to. Right over here.
This island is amazing!
This is the main fishing lake at the school. Rivers feed into it, and that's why there are so many different types of fish here.
Just a little bit more!
Find where the river flows out to the lake. It's called it's a really interesting place. Alright. Feeds into the ocean. That would be here.
Great!
Great, you found it. See how the fresh water drains into the ocean? All the bodies of water work together. Isn't it wonderful?
I'm counting on you.
Walk down the wooden stairs to the signal and check out the waterfall at the ocean. Okay.
Wow!
The ocean is always salty and there's so many different types of animals that live in it.
Talk to me!
We should have swimming races one of these days. For now, though, just come back and talk to me. Alright.
You're wonderful!
You're going to be a well-rounded student in no time. Remember, a good Viking needs to use their brain just as much as their body. Alright. And that is level 10 for Snifflesnuff. Let's go age him up now, and then take him for a little flight. Okay. Here we go. I think I'll just keep the colors. I like them. So yeah, there is Snifflesnuff. Now an adult. No difference in size, but he's now capable of flight. Alright. I see Hiccup has a quest for us down there, so let's go talk to him.
You're doing amazing!
Congratulations, your dragon's now ready to fly and join the dragon racing. Talk to Astrid about her favorite pastime. Alright. Talked to Astrid a lot today.
I really appreciate it.
Welcome to Thunder Run Racing. Here you can prove your dragon the best by testing its speed against other dragon riders.
I'm counting on you.
Go inside the Thunder Run Racing building next to me and join the next race. Alright. See how Snifflesnuff does in racing. Okay. Well, just start up a race here. Okay, ready to race. So I don't think the speed is too high on this level back. What are we facing? The Light Fury, Rumblehorn. I know we can beat the Rumblehorn probably. Those guys are really slow. Anyways, Light Fury will be a bit difficult though. Alright. Whoop, turn rate is very awful on this guy. It's been a while since I've raced too. Ugh. Wow. I underestimated the Rumblehorn. Woo. Yeah, I don't recommend using Zippleback for racing. Yeah, you'll probably be better off with like a Deadly Natter or Monstrous Nightmare. Ooh. All right, we're trying. Well, how is that person in fourth place? Was there another contestant that I didn't see? Thought there was just three of us. Ah, yep, the turn rate. Okay, final lap. Ooh. Can't even see where I'm going now, no. Miss my snorri for these. Oh, great. See, you go out of order once, and it is very hard to recover. Okay, turn. Oh, Zippleback's turn rate. You know what? Well, there we go. Two trophies. First two trophies for our Viking here. Woo, that was some pretty impressive flying. Are you sure, Astrid? Didn't seem impressive to me. Anyways, I just want to actually see quickly what are the Zippleback stats. Turn rate 5, acceleration 4, max speed 5.8, pitch rate 8. Yeah, not a dragon that I would bring into racing, but you know what, we're doing a playthrough here, so I could have taken my Sand Wraith, I probably would have gotten a better chance, but oh well. Well guys, I think that'll be it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and I hope to see you guys in the next School of Dragons video.